Now, if we all are living in this world and we are going through so many tests, how do we cope with this test, Mola? How do we cope with this test? And we find our answers in Kalame Mola. Kalame Mola, chapter 208, Mola Ali has said, Saburi teri tujhpate deve jis kisi upar aave bala. Jo ve suburi kare tu usko fate deve bujhe aap Allah. Saburi karnhar ko rab dost rakhe aap rab kare anant pyar. Banda bhala ve jo saburi kare to kathan vela rab hove uska yaar. Your patience will give you success. And this applies to anyone who has difficulty, any bala, any difficulty. The one who exercises patience, to him, Mola will grant success. And Mola befriends those who are sabir. Saburi karanhar ko rab dost rakhe. And we are seeking Mola's friendship. And this is the criteria for his friendship. Are we sabir? Are we patient or not? Or we are complaining? And then he says, Aap rab kare anant pyar. Do we not want his love? He would love us more if we are patient. Banda bhala ve jo saburi kare. The one who is patient in difficult time, then Mola will be his friend. Mola will come to support him, help him. Then in other words, it says, Nemat pai ne shukr na kiya, to na shukri nemat ko le jaye si. Nemat pai ne shukr na kiya, to na shukri nemat ko le jaye si. Nemat pai tab na chetiya, to nemat gai piche pachtaye si. Haya dunya nemat to phal deve, jo shukr ibadat ki. Jo e na kare, to jine diti hayati. So leve hayati bin phal chheen. If we get Mola's blessing, what is Mola's blessing? Today, if we are alive and breathing, it is Mola's blessing. And if we will not be shukar guzar, then what will Mola do? He will take away the namat. So today, when we again bedtime, we will have to think what blessings has he given us in our life. And are we truly shukar guzar of his blessings or we are complaining? You know, we do here, right? Count your blessings. And that's what Mola is saying. And nemat pai tabna chetya, meaning when I blessed you, when you were given all the blessings and then you did not realize it, then what will happen? You'll regret it when you lose it. Let it be life, let it be your health, let it be money, whatever it is. So let's take example of life. The life, Mola has said here, Hayat dunya nemat to phal deve jo shukar ibadat ki. The reason we are alive in this world, the reason we have this breath, to do bandagi, to do shukar guzari. When we will have no life, then we have no free will to do bandagi. Similarly, if I have this worldly blessings, of my house or my earnings, my children, am I using them in a right direction, directing them in the right direction? If I'm not, then I'm not shukr guzar. And then it will be taken away from me and then I will realize it. If we are not grateful of things and people in our life, we will lose them. And then it's only regret which we will have. In other words, nek aadmi ne jo dukh paya to jano rehmat rab ne bheji. This is our answer. Nek aadmi ne jo dukh paya to jano rehmat rab ne bheji. If a good pious person, a mu'min person has worldly difficulties, tribulations, trials, know that it's a blessing sent by Mola to him. Or fasik jo dukh paya to kartoot se bala us par aayi. Now if similar experiences are given to those who are not pious, then do know that it is because of their actions. Ayub Nabi ka dukhda rehmat jo kire pade sare an. Ayub Nabi ka dukhda rehmat jo kire pade sare an. Firon duba is bala jo larta tha Musa Nabi ke san. Now Prophet Ayub. Prophet, it's a prophet we are talking about. He was a prophet who had this disease. He had this worms on all over his body. Prophet, messenger, pious, ibadati, had worms all over his body. And the story goes that he would even then wake up for ibadat and he could not stand up because he was sick. So he would hold on to his wife's hair to stand up to do ibadat, because he would do ibadat by standing up. And if any worm falls out of his skin, he would pick it up and put it back in the skin, saying that my body is your food, so I would let you eat your food. No complaints. A prophet, this level of test on prophet, who are we? And when we complain, we need to ask ourselves, who are we? Firon duba is bala jo ladta tha Musa Nabi ke sang. Firon, who was a worldly king, but he drowned in the ocean because he was fighting with Musa. There is a beautiful verse in Quran, chapter 2, verse 153. It says, In Allah ma'as sabirin. Indeed, Allah is with patient. So to sum up today's topic, tests are must in our life. Allah says it in Quran, in Farman, Mawla says, don't ask for parak. But that does not mean that he will not test us. He will test us. And it was so simple test that that man, him having a wife, a spouse, good house, good food, it was enough test for that man. Are we in the same test? We will have to look into ourselves. Whatever tests we are in, we will have to see if we are complaining about it or we are grateful. We are using that as an opportunity to elevate ourselves, to do more Giriyawazari. Because it is easier to do Giriyawazari when we are in pain. It is easier. When we are happy, when we are busy with the worldly things, we do not remember Mawla. It is a practice to fall in love with Mawla, to stay with like-minded friends who would remind us that this difficulty, it's given by Mawla, it's okay, this shall pass too. And yes, it is okay to share with a trustworthy, like-minded friend so you can get it out of your chest and you can deal with it. Do not let it stay inside you. When you keep it inside you, Shaitan takes advantage of it. It keeps repeating that tape in your head. It keeps repeating it. And when you keep repeating it, what happens? You're not remembering to do zikr. And you keep pitying on yourself. And you keep complaining because you are in that crap. So it is okay. It is very human to share it with somebody who is on the true path, who will remind that this is just a sharing. No backbiting. Once you have talked about it, done, delete. No more talk about it. Move on. And you do need a like-minded friend who will help you to keep in check. Are you backbiting or are you really having difficulty to deal with this issue in your life? You're suffering due to whatever is happening. So deal with that emotion, difficulty. Be shukar guzar, be patient, and elevate our ranks by doing Giriyawazari. And then do not be the victim of khaufe beja. Fear of others. There is no pretension needed. For a moment, this world is funny. I don't need to please people. I don't need to fit in. Yes, I do want to become so beautiful that my Mawla loves me. Become free. People around us who are not on true knowledge, they'll judge us. No matter what you do, you cannot please people. So why to worry about them? Be surrounded by like-minded friends who are on true path, learning true knowledge, who will help you elevate your ranks. And then When you free yourself from the fear of people, then you start practicing working hard to learn to love Mala. There are two ways, the treatment is in two ways. Fear with fear and fear replaced by ishq. When children are younger, who do not know accountability of their actions, you know, the strategy to teach them is fear. If you will not do your homework, you'll be grounded. Because the child doesn't know that the doing of homework is so important, will be, he needs it, he doesn't realize it. As a parent, parent knows it. So parent is giving consequences of fear. You will have no pocket money, whatever. So the child would behave in a way which is good for him. The question here would be, when our peers were teaching us at that time, that was a different time. Today, we're being educated in a worldly ways. Are we still behaving like children or we are grown-ups? Are we accountable for our action? Do we still want us to live in fear or in love of Imam? Both paths are there, and it is our choice, because both the teachings are from our peers. It is our choice. And Quran clearly says, "Inna Allaha ma'as sabirin." Allah is with those who are patient. So if we are patient, we are not complaining, and we are seeking Tawfiq, Ta'id, Himmat, Yari, asking him to become our friend, give us his ishq in our heart. If, imagine, Deen Dunya ka Malik, if he is with us, can we be in any difficulty? Whatever difficulty we have, it's of no value. It does not mean that we do not get worn out, we don't have to deal with things. Yes, we do have to do whatever we are dealing with. But the strength comes from the name of Allah. So if we focus our energy in the right direction, it will help us. So I would end here, and if friends have questions, please, you can ask questions. Does anyone has any question?
Just want to tell you, I'm going to leave, but I really am very, very happy. I've been hearing you very calmly, and I'm so happy to hear you. Thank you very much. May God bless you. Allah keep you happy and healthy.
Can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you, Hanif.
Yes, Hanif. Yeah, you know my name, my voice. You know, a very beautiful talk. And another thing about the difficulties in the life, there's a beautiful ayat in Quran. On no soul doth Allah place a burden greater than it can bear.
Yes.
It gains every good that it earns. It gains every ill that it earns. Then there's a prayer in this same ayat. Pray, our Lord, condemn us not if we forget or fall into error. Our Lord, lay not on us a burden greater than we have the strength to bear. Blot out our sins, just forgiveness, have mercy upon us. You are our protector. Protect us from those who stand against faith. I think it's 2255, if I'm not mistaken, or 286, one of those. But this is so beautiful, because Allah, whatever he puts on us, he won't put on us unless he knows we can bear it. And it's up to us to have the patience to, inshallah, bear what he is putting on us and remember him. I just wanted to add that.
Yes. Shukram. Thank you.
Amati, I just wanted to find out, so let's say if you have a child that has not been regular in religious, or is and you're not aware, and is going through issues of his own, like, or her own, can you pray, or can one pray on behalf of the child?
Yes.
For forgiveness and to give Sadbuddhi, Samaj, and bring them on the path of Sirat al-Mustaqim and ease their difficulties.
We do this every day, Yasmin.
I know, yeah. So like, for example, I know I do. So if we have anything and we can do it, and that touches that soul as well.
True, very true. Yes. So
Just
if we
like
are
we do for the
listening.
Jumla Jamaat, right? We say for Kul Jamaat, Kul Insaniyat, we do that. So we do it with that niyat, and
Yes.
your niyat, inshallah, gets accepted.
Yes, and you can do that for individual person too. Let's say if we have a child in front of us who is going through difficulties, we can truly make an intention for that child and pray. And we can do that. Whatever you want to pray for that child, it does help his soul.
And normally when you say your niyats, like do you say your niyats, does it matter whether you say it before or whether you say it after your kiryasari?
Normally you need to know why are you praying, for whom you are praying.
Right,
but sometimes
exactly.
It happens when you're in flow and at that time when you remember things. And it's okay to, there and there you're making that niyat. It's just a thought, matter of thought. You said this niyat in your thought and you're doing and you're praying and it's okay.
Okay, all right, okay. Just need that clarification. And one more thing, I know everybody, when they recite or when they do Kiryazari, and I know we use that tasbih, is there a particular the amount of paras that we say our Kiryazari? Is it 7, 11, 33, 40? Like, is there a specific amount of paras or the times that we take out the tasbih or do the Kiryazari on a particular Kiryazari that we're doing?
So,
or does it just depend on oneself?
So, Kiryazari is an action.
Yes.
So, the way we are doing the zikr with Kiryazari.
Yes, yes.
So, how many beads of zikr we do with Kiryazari?
Right.
Right? Okay.
Right.
So, it's up to you, whatever time you have. 40, number 40 has been praised in Quran too. So,
okay.
It's good to do 40 times. That's why
okay.
we're doing this intention zikr for 40 days.
Okay.
And scientifically, it has been proven that if you want to bring a change, if you do one practice for 40 days, it will become part of your habit. And that's
okay.
why we are, as a group, we are doing this zikr for 40 days. So we mm-hmm. make it a habit of ours. It's not just going to last till 40, but it will continue with each one of us to continue to do this zikr. So 40 is the quantity, but on the other hand, it is always good to do more than less. So yeah, you understand the reasoning. In Jamaat, when they do things in congregation, there are so many different reasons. But
right.
as individuals, we do know that 40, I would say minimum, 100 is good, 1,000 is very good. So why not? The more we remember, the better it is.
Alhamdulillah, shukr. Thank you so much for answering that. Appreciate it.
Thank you. There's one more question which I see on the chat, and it is that can we give the som on the behalf of the deceased family member? So I would say simply that the deceased member, when they die, all the bhulchuk is being forgiven with the chanta. And if you desire to do something for the deceased member, there's no harm. You can do that. But remember, with our lives, with free will, what we do matters the most. When we are sending dua or doing salwat, the hisab kitab is such that 99 times it's our benefit and one time Ruhani's benefit. It does reach Ruhani, but it's a very small quantity. So it's up to you to do whatever will give you the peace of your heart. Because when you ask this question, meaning that somewhere in your heart this sorrow is there, you can surely pray for the Ruhani and do whatever you like to, but he or she has been given that chanta of forgiveness of whatever. And then it is up to Mola, and we all keep praying for Ruhani every day. And Mola is forgiver of the sins. He will forgive the sins. So I hope I have answered the question. If not, you can always come back to me.
Yeah, Niyamat equation hai. इंडिविजुअल पर्सन के लिए जब जिक्र की तस्बीह अपन निकालते हैं तो इट डजंट मैटर कि अपन पहले उनके लिए दुआ मांग लेते हैं या बाद में मांगते हैं. इट्स जस्ट थॉट, जैसे आपने बोला राइट, कि पहले आप दुआ मांग के तस्बीह स्टार्ट करते हो या तस्बीह फिनिश के बाद जब सिजदा देते हो जब भी दुआ मांगते हो तो डजंट मैटर.
आपकी गिरियाजारी की प्रैक्टिस है कि आप जो इंटेंशन है वो ये है कि आप जो है रोजाना जिक्र करने तस्बीह करने बैठेंगे
पर्सन के लिए कुछ दुआ मांगते तो वो मतलब पहले मांगो या बाद में, बस वो सुनने वाला तो है और थॉट अपना क्या है.
राइट रिमेम्बर वी डिड टॉक अबाउट इट कि दुआ उस वक्त कबूल होती है जब आंखें नम होती हैं, तो जब दिल नम हो और आंखें नम हो उस वक्त दुआ करना ज्यादा फायदेमंद है बजाय इसके कि सूखी आंखों के साथ।
वो तो गिरियासारी के टाइम पे तो खुद ही खुद बस वो मौला की एक नियामत है कि जब बस अपनी आंखें गिली हो ही जाती है. या दैट्स ट्रू.
बिल्कुल।
शुक्रिया.
वन
थैंक यू.
मोर क्वेश्चन आई सी, थैंक यू करिश्मा। इफ यू आर डूइंग जिक्र एंड देयर इज नो टारगेट फॉर इंटेंशन ओनली फॉर अल्लाहस प्रोटेक्शन, यस यू कैन डू दैट। अल्लाहस प्रोटेक्शन इज आल्सो दुआ अ नियत दैट यू वी सीक। वी ऑल सीक मौलास प्रोटेक्शन, पना या मौला, अमान या मौला, बिकॉज वी सीक प्रोटेक्शन फ्रॉम इंसी एंड जिन्नी शैतान, राइट? इंसी शैतान, somebody comes and back bites in our ears and that goes into our heart. That's the इंसी शैतान। जिन्नी शैतान इज इनविजिबल, गिव्स अस थॉट्स एंड मेक्स अस कमिट सिंस इन आवर थॉट्स। सो ऑफ कोर्स वी हैव टू कीप सीकिंग प्रोटेक्शन फ्रॉम मौला, ऑलवेज प्रोटेक्ट अस मौला। सो दैट इज ऑल्सो इन इट सेल्फ इज एन इंटेंशन।
याली मदद नियामत.
मौलाई मदद।
लेकिन है ना, एक्स्ट्रा जिक्र का टाइम नहीं होता है और मुझे ऐसा फील होता है लाइक हम जब इबादत भी करते तस्बीह, इबादत में भी चलो ध्यान की दूसरी बात है वो भी नहीं लगता है, लेकिन जब जिक्र भी तस्बीह भी पढ़ती हूँ ना तो मुझे लाइक ऐसा फील होता है कि लाइक यू नो ये सब ऊपर से हो रहा है. जब बहुत इंटेंस से कभी कभी हमें करती हूँ जिक्र, लेकिन एक्स्ट्रा जिक्र जो आप बता रहे हैं वैसा हमारे पास टाइम नहीं होता है मेरे पास. तो आई मीन मुझे ये पूछना था कि इतना जरूरी है इंटेंस जिक्र करना, उन्हें उस गिरियावाजारी के बगैर तो वो इबादत भी नहीं हो सकती. पर सच में हमारे पास टाइम नहीं होता तो क्या करें. बिजी लाइफ, लाइक मैं जॉब पे जाती हूँ शाम को आके फिर यू नो
सब बिजी है
रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटीज.
यार, सब बिजी है, राइट? हम सब बिजी हैं, लेकिन एक
हाँ
इंसान है ना, तो थोड़ा सा शायद नींद में से वक्त निकालना होगा थोड़ा किसी। अगर आप, अगर इतनी मुश्किल होती है ना, तो व्हाट यू नीड टू डू, आई वुड टेल यू एन एक्सरसाइज। आप लिखिए सुबह से कि आप क्या क्या करते हैं, एक
जी.
दो 24 घंटे या टू फॉर 2 डेज राइट डाउन व्हाट यू डू। यू विल ऑनेस्टली सिंसियरली फाइंड कि आप टाइम जो है कहाँ से निकाल सकते हैं, क्योंकि हम सोते तो है ना, हम खाते तो है ना। अगर मौला से इश्क है तो सोना क्या हम कर सकते हैं? आधा घंटा मौला को दे सकते हैं? तो ये जो ना वो इश्क का मामला है। जो आशिकी होती है ना, तो ना भूख नजर आती है, ना खाना, ना नींद, कुछ नजर नहीं आती है। तो अगर हम आशिक हैं तो फिर ये सवाल ही खत्म हो जाता है।
एक्चुअली जॉब पे भी 8-9 आवर्स निकल जाते हैं लाइक यू नो पूरा टाइम इसके लिए
आई एम श्योर हम सब, ऑलमोस्ट एवरीबॉडी वर्क्स, राइट? बहुत ही
वर्क ही
कम।
करता है ना. सही है इंशाल्लाह. तो ये जो आपका एतकाफ का आपने जो बताया है, आई नेवर हर्ड के लाइक यू नो मुसलमान जो लोग सुन्नी लोग जो मस्जिदों में करते हैं रसूल के टाइम पे भी एतकाफ करते थे, पर ये जो आपका करता है लाइक यू नो फर्स्ट टाइम आई हर्ड इट. मैं आपको सुन रही हूँ, आपके ज्यादा रिकॉर्डिंग ही सुनती हूँ, आज मौका मिला है आपको लाइव सुनने का. तो लाइक
तो
इसका ये कहाँ से हुआ, लाइक फर्स्ट टाइम मैंने ये तारी तस्बीहां भी सुनी है.
मैं आपको एक बात बताऊं, मैं पहले मुसलमान हूँ फिर इस्माइली हूँ, राइट?
जी. हम पहले मुसलमान हैं फिर इस्माइली हैं, शिया इस्माइली
तो
मुसलमान
बहुत सारी जो प्रैक्टिसेस वी बीइंग मुस्लिम जो हमको नहीं मालूम थी, एंड वी आर लर्निंग, सो इट्स अ गुड थिंग हम लर्न कर रहे
है.
हैं। और
जी
जिक्र
जी
जो है वो हमारे इमामों का, हमारे पैगंबरों का शेवा है। कुरान में हजरत मूसा अलैहिस्सलाम के बारे में बताया जाता है कि उन्होंने 40 दिन का एहतिकाफ किया। बीबी मरियम के बारे में बताया जाता है, हजरत जिकरिया अलैहिस्सलाम के बारे में बताया जाता है, एंड वो हमारे लिए रोल मॉडल्स हैं। तो हम उनके फुटस्टेप पे इसलिए चल रहे हैं कि उन्होंने पैगंबरी पाई, इमाम की क्लोजनेस पाई, हम भी तो यही चाह रहे हैं। तो जो उन्होंने किया हम भी करें ना, ताकि हम भी पहुंच जाए मौला के करीब, राइट?
जी हाँ, रसूल के जमाने में सुन्नी लोग अभी भी मस्जिदों में करते हैं ना एहतिकाफ, लेकिन आरोनो किस तरह करते हैं कभी देखा नहीं है उन लोगों को करते हुए, लेकिन सुना है कि 40 दिन का एहतिकाफ करते हैं क्योंकि रसूल के जमाने से वो चीज चली आ रही है.
इंटेंशन हम भी करते हैं। हम जो है पूरी रात का, जब लैलतुल कदर की रात होती है, वो भी हमारी भी नियत होती है कि पूरी रात जाग के हम करेंगे। तो एतकाफ का जो लफ्जी माना है वो इंटेंशन है। आपने आई थिंक वो आर्टिकल्स पढ़े हैं नाचिस,
जी सही है. एक और क्वेश्चन पूछूं कोई, अगर आपके पास टाइम है तो.
माय फ्रेंड
अच्छा
हियर शी इज सेइंग जस्ट अबाउट इंटेंशन। शी सेज दैट शी हैड हर्ड अबाउट इंटेंशन इन मुस्लिम कम्युनिटी, मुस्लिम फ्रेंड्स। शी इज फ्रॉम पाकिस्तान एंड शी इज सेइंग शी इज सरप्राइज्ड दैट वी बीइंग स्माइलीज we do intention too, and I'm telling her that if we were to look at our role models, those who were close to Imam, they all did intention, and if we know that setting an intention and doing more zikr, giving investing more time in zikr and Imam's love, It will bring us close to Imam. So why would we not do that? All right. So that's what we talked about. Okay. आपके और क्या सवाल है?
जी मुझे ना एक ये पूछना था कि इबादत में कितनी भी कोशिश करें हम कितना भी फरमान पढ़ें जो भी करें फिर भी एक तरह का ध्यान नहीं लगता लेकिन ज्यादातर ध्यान चला जाता है उसके लिए मतलब ऐसा किसी गिरियाजारी रात को करनी चाहिए या सुबह उठ के करनी चाहिए किस तरफ वक्त में ऐसा करें कि लाइक ना पूरा फोकस रहे इबादत में
इबादत के लिए आसान तरीका ये है कि हम 4 बजे ना उठें 3 बजे उठें और 3 बजे उठ के हम जिक्र करें अगर अगर आपके लिए दिन में वक्त नहीं है तो नींद कुर्बानी कर सकते हैं और 3 बजे उठ के जो है आप तस्बीहात निकालें गिरियाजारी करें और फिर आप बंदगी में बैठें तो वो बंदगी जो है वो बहुत ही आला लेवल की होगी और आपका दिल भी नरम होगा आप जाग भी गए होंगे और खूब अच्छे से तस्बीह जिक्र करने के बाद जब आप इबादत में बैठेंगे तो बहुत फायदा होगा
तो ये कौन सी तस्बीहात जो आपके जिक्र को आप जो कर रहे हैं 40 दिन की वो वाले ज्यादातर
आपको जो दिल चाहे जिससे आपका दिल कनेक्ट हो ये तो हम साथ ही मिलके हम सीख रहे हैं कुछ नए जिक्र को आपका जो आपका दिल चाहता है आप जिक्र करें जिक्र के जो भी जिक्र करते हैं उसके माना को समझ के उसमें अपने दिल को डाल के गिरिया उजारी के साथ जिक्र करें तो बात बनती है
जी
ठीक है ना तो अगेन दिस फ्रेंड इज आस्किंग दैट इन इबादत यू नो इट्स हार्ड टू स्टे अटेंटिव And how do we do that? So I'm simply saying that we need to do Giriyazari and Zikr probably at 3 a.m. We need to wake up early. And then, so 3 to 4, we do Zikr, we do Giriyazari, and then 4 to 5, when we do Bandagi, it's a different level of sitting and Bandagi because it has melt 3 to 4, the Zikr, the Giriyazari melts our heart. And then when you do the Bandagi, it's you would have better connection. It does not matter what zikr. We are not learning a special zikr. Zikr is all Maula's name. But whenever you do any zikr, please learn its translation, learn its meaning, and then connect to it completely and then do the zikr. We should not do zikr like a parrot. Yali, 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 yali. That does not help us. Agar tote ko bhi sikha diya jaye, to wo bhi kar lega zikr. Then what is the difference between us and a Parrot. All right. Any other question?
Thank you. Yeah. Thank you very much. Yeah.
So Yasmin, जो है वो आपको ये बोल रही है अभी आप जो दोस्त आप बोल रहे थे नाम I do not know
जी जी
आपका
नाम फरजाना
फरजाना तो फरजाना मैंने तो शायद थोड़ा सख्त जवाब दिया यास्मीन जो है आपकी बहन आपको दिल से ये बोल रही है कि आप जब चाय भी पी रहे हैं तभी आप याली का नाम ले सकते हैं बिजीनेस जो ना फिजिकल बिजी एक अलग चीज होती है और यहाँ का बिजीनेस अलग होता है यहाँ का बिजीनेस को कम करना होता है समटाइम्स व्हेन वी आर डूइंग थिंग्स वी थिंक ऑफ ये करना है ये करना है ये करना है ये करना है एंड वी आर फीलिंग वेरी बिजी ये भी शैतान की एक बाजी है वी नीड टू स्टॉप थिंकिंग थॉट्स जो करना है करना है वंस प्लान कर लिया एंड देन दैट्स इट अब जिक्र चलेगा इधर जिसम काम करेगा यहाँ जिक्र चलेगा सो वी कैन डू दैट लेकिन ये कि ये हमारी नियत होनी चाहिए और इस पे अमल होना चाहिए इट इज वेरी मच पॉसिबल एंड आई कैन टेल यू एग्जांपल यासी ने ये एक्सपीरियंस किया है इसलिए ये आपको ये बोल रही है
शुक्रिया
याली मदद फ्रेंड्स
याली मदद